Thank you. Okay, thank you everyone for coming out to our midwinter band concert. We have to come up with creative names for these concerts because winter is so long around North Dakota that there's several winter concerts actually. So this is the midwinter concert. I think at the end we can finally do the spring concert, but that comes kind of later on here. So thank you so much. We started with a piece that was called Haven Dance. That composer, David Holsinger, was a really a pretty popular composer in the 1980s into the early 90s for band. That title, Haven Dance, he actually had three children. Haven was his eldest. I think I mentioned this in the program notes. Haven was his eldest and it was his daughter. And it kind of depicted, as young kids often do, not a care in the world, just dancing around the house in kind of a whirlwind as kids can tend to do. He actually wrote three dances and a separate one for each of his boys. So there's a Niles dance and a Grayson dance. Of all the dances he wrote, I think this is probably the best one. So that's why I introduced this to our students and it was the first one he wrote. So next, we're gonna go on to one of Frank DeKelly's earliest compositions for the wind band. This is his setting of Amazing Grace. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
So there's a couple pieces on this concert. I always try to select music that's of high quality and worth doing. There's a couple pieces on this concert that I've got a personal connection with. And I think we probably all have those experiences from time to time. And it may not be in a band saying this, or it might be in a choir, or it might be just something you remember from your childhood. Or, you know, music is really interwoven through our life experiences, and we can often recall these things. I was telling the students earlier about this piece, this next piece, this Divergence. It's a short symphony in four movements for band. And I was telling them that my very first experience and serious experience with this piece was when I was in high school. And I realize now, since I've directed a few times as a teacher, that when I was in high school, I suppose I was probably in 10th grade, I don't think I was really probably playing my part right on this very much. It's a pretty serious and pretty hard music. And I don't know, I remember having an important musical connection with the piece because it really sounded neat, but I don't think I was playing my part right very often. It's a pretty challenging piece. And then later on, because I remembered that when I actually got my first teaching job in a rural town in Minnesota, I found this piece, and it was the first piece I took with the band to large group contest, and they played it way better than the high school band I was in ever played it, and certainly the tuba player played it way better than I did as a tuba player. And so this piece keeps popping up. I've probably done it twice as a high school director. I did it once in graduate school as a conducting student. And I think I might have done it my first year here, which seems like just yesterday, but this is actually my seventh year here. Can you believe it? So it came back around, and it seemed like it was the right time to expose a new group of students to this piece. So in my opinion, this is probably Francis Macbeth's probably his best piece. His Of Sailors and Whales is really fantastic as well. He's got a couple good ones, but this one is just really, really exceptional. Just his use of overlaying meters on top of each other, and his use of the percussion, and just how creative it is. It's really just got a really rich, beautiful sound to it. So this is Divergence, and it's a short symphony in four movements. We hope you enjoy this work.
Thank you.
Next, we're going to have one of our students come up and take us through the next piece, Stephen Reinke's Heaven's Light. I always try to do this with all the students that are approaching the end of their classwork here. Our guest conductor tonight, and I've only gotten to know her over the last couple years. She was actually a transfer student, but she's really played a vital part in this ensemble as a clarinetist, and she's a really terrific musician, and she's kind of nearing the end. Are you student teaching in the fall? Is that right? Okay, so this is the perfect time for us to invite Kyla Burnett up to take us through Heaven's Light. So please welcome Kyla to the stage.
Thank you.
So, great job, Kyla, by the way. Yay. So I said there's really two pieces on this concert that I have some sort of a personal connection to. This next one, I remember playing really for the first time when I really started taking music seriously in college. And I was part of a couple high-performing groups, and we'd travel and we'd play at the state convention and stuff. I remember playing this live at the Minnesota Music Educators Association conference on kind of like the spot, like the premier performance. And it was kind of part of this professional wind ensemble. It was in this Twin Ports Wind Orchestra. And everything about the piece was incredibly moving to me. You can read in the program a little bit about what it's about. It's basically a dedication to survivors throughout the world of child abuse. And it has some various imagery and painting through sound, or some tone painting throughout. It starts off innocent. At times, you can kind of hear this childlike hymn throughout the piece. And then kind of in the middle, you get the sense, or Camp House kind of brings in this tune, this very dark, sinister tune, and it's supposed to kind of represent this evil, dark figure that appears in many child's lives. And I think there's really no doubt when that comes up in the music, it's actually kind of dark and pretty terrifying. And then at the end, as he does in some of his serious works that he dedicates to various causes, he wants it, it doesn't end, I can't say it ends on a positive note, but at the end you get a sense or a glimmer of hope. And that's what he really hopes this piece would instill in the end, that there is hope, hope for survivors. So I think I've said enough. We'll let the music do the rest of the talking. This is Mark Camphouse's Watchmen Tell Us of the Night. Thank you again, everyone, for coming out tonight. We really enjoy playing live music for you and live music in this hall. It's nice to be able to do that again. We've been doing this more regularly recently, but it was pretty tough for a while when things got shut down, and we're just really grateful we get to do this and that you're able to safely come out and enjoy this concert. So we have one last march. This is the Radetzky March, and it's certainly not a traditional American concert band march. I think you'll get definitely a different feel from this. I think you'll really enjoy it. We love playing this piece. So have a great night and safe travels, and we'll hope to see you back in warmer months for our final concert of the year. Thanks again.